the first unit of history for class 10 standard, which is the rise of nationalism in Europe. Before we begin with the rise of nationalism in Europe, actually you need to know a little about the background of Europe and what the term nationalism means. Basically, when you know we see the development of the civilizations of the world, there have been dynasties and monarchies for a long period. There have been empires ruled by kings or queens. But slowly what happened was the transition from monarchy, from an empire, to the transition of... These days it is very easier to understand the concept of a nation, because these days we don't see dynasties and empires anywhere. For us, it is very easy to visualize what a nation is. Like, I belong to a certain country, I share a sense of identity with fellow citizens of my country. I'm not accountable or answerable to one particular, king or queen or the ruler of an empire. But how did this transition, how did the concept of nations first came into being? How did it emerge for the first time? So that happened in Europe, where you see, this concept of belonging to a nation means what? Nationalism. And this concept of nationalism arose in Europe in the mid-19th centuries. Earlier what happened was, we have seen last year that, after French dominion for centuries, the people got really agitated, and there was a French Revolution that happened. The public took power in their own hands, and, the Tsar was killed and the dynasty was overthrown. But then still the concept of a nation had not come into existence. So in this unit, what you're going to study is how nationalism arose in Europe and then later spread to other parts of the world. Before we begin with the rise of nationalism in Europe, there is a painting given in the textbook, which was painted by a French painter, Frédéric Soriou, in 1848. He printed a series of four prints, in which the first print was, the dream of worldwide democratic and social republics. He had this dream, he first envisaged and he brought it out into the open in the form of a painting, that there is a concept of liberty and freedom that you can see in this painting, and also the concept of nationalism being shown for the first time. What you see in this painting is that, the Statue of Liberty is standing with a torch of enlightenment in left hand and the Charter of Rights of Man in the right hand. So, the ideal of liberty and freedom was personified as a female at that time. So you see the Statue of Liberty with two very famous symbols, the Torch of Enlightenment and the Charter of Rights of Man, in each of our hands. Then you see, the different peoples of different nations marching together in front of that statue. And in this procession, you will see that the first thing is, USA, Switzerland are leading the procession, because they were the countries which had already achieved the concept of a nation. They had already developed, crossed that state of liberty. They were not under any dynasties, or they were not being oppressed by any other nation. Then you see France and Germany following them later. France is following. It has just reached the Statue of Liberty, and Germany, surprisingly, although it had not recognized itself as a separate nation at that time, still, Frédéric Soriou painted them, the people of Germany, carrying a national flag. So the people of different nations were identified in this procession that is painted by carrying their particular national flag. This is something, how a national flag came to be identified with the identity of a nation. To bring a collective sense of unity, there had to be a national flag, and people have this feeling that they have to respect their national flag, which brings a sense of identity, or makes you identify with your nation. So you see people carrying national flags of different countries, wearing their national costumes, marching in a procession. So Frédéric Soriou, and also in the forefront you will see shattered remains of absolutist governments, like you see a crown in the front or broken chains. So and you will see Jesus Christ and the angels in the from the skies, they are looking over this procession. That was a symbol of fraternity, that they are blessing this kind of, nationalist agenda or nationalist feelings. So this was one painting that predicted that, Europe was going through a...